Today's section is different types of functions in Excel. Types of functions. In Excel, we have different types of functions. There are mathematical functions, logical functions, text functions, lookup and reference functions, financial functions. These are the different types of functions available in the Excel. Here, I am taking the first function as financial function. For this financial function, I have to take some data in the Excel sheet. Here, I am taking the sample Excel sheet over here, column A, column B, column C, column D, column E, and column F. Row 1, row 2, row 3. In this, I have to fill some data. Here in A1 cell, I am writing the name of the customer and bank name. And in C1 cell, I am taking as a loan amount and then rate of interest. And then the month. And then in F1 cell, I am taking as the PMT. And in G1 cell, PPMT, and in H1 cell, IPMT. I have to fill some data in the Excel sheet. Here, I'm taking the customer name and then the fourth customer name. And here I'm taking the bank details, that means SBI, ICICI, and Axis Bank. The loan amount I have to enter here. That means 1,50,000 and again 1,50,000 and 2 lakh amount. And the rate of interest is 5% and then 7% and 6%. Or you can take it as an, for ICICI Bank, you can take it as 4% here. And then the months. You can enter the months in the E2 cell. That means 24 months for second person, also 24 months, and the third person 36 months. We have to calculate the PP, PMT, PPMT, and IPMT. For this purpose, for calculating the PMT and the next ones, go for the formula tab, click on the formula tab and then click on the insert function. Then it will be displayed with FX. Insert function dialog box will be appeared. This is the insert function dialog box. In this insert function dialog box, the first one is the select category. That means the type of function you have to select. Click on this down arrow mark, types of functions will be appeared here. In this, you have to select financial function. Financial function, and in this function type. Again, one box will be appeared. In this box, you can see the PMT, PPMT, FV, PV, IP, MT list over here. In this, you have to select the PMT and click on the OK button. At last, you can see two buttons, OK button and the cancel button. Click on the OK button. I am selecting the PMT and clicking on the OK button. When you are clicking on the OK button, then PMT dialog box will be appeared. This is the PMT dialog box for insert option. In this dialog box, you can see the rate with one box, and here it will display number. Why it is displaying the number means you have to enter some number in this box. And then NPR, again, number, and then after NPR, PV, and FV. And type. And at last, you can see the two buttons like OK button and the cancel button. This is the dialog box of a PMT. And here, rate, we have to enter some number here. I am not at all entering any number, just I am selecting the cell. What cell I have to select means, here for displaying the rate means we have to divide it by with 12 number. That means total months is 12. I have to divide this with 12 number. That means the rate of interest. I have to select the D2 cell. Whenever I am clicking on this cell, then automatically the cell number will be displayed here. That cell reference number is D2 and I am giving slash over here and I am entering 12. That means this 5% is dividing with 12 number. 12 means 12 months here. And then NPR. How to calculate the NPR means, click on the month. That means you have to click on this E2 cell. That means 24. If you are clicking on the 24 means it will take it as a reference ID as E2. And then the PV means click on the loan. Loan means C2. It will take the C2. That means 1,50,000 amount. The reference ID is C2. And then click on the OK button. If you are clicking on the OK button, then it will display the PMT value here. And the value is 6,580 point some number. And this is the answer for the calculating PMT. That means PMT means here installment plus interest. PMT means installment plus interest for 1 month or 1 year. For 1 month, I am calculating the how much amount I have to pay. And PPMT means here I am taking the and next go to the insert function and click on the PPMT option and click on OK button. Then again you can see the dialog box of PPMT and here again rate with some dialog box and number. After that, you can see the PAR and NPER. That means you can take the numbers here. And then next, you can see the FV. How to calculate the PPMT means, for rate purpose, you have to select the one number here. That means, how I can select the one number for this rate means, same rate calculated with 5%, and then here I have to enter one number, and then NPR means for month. Month means click on the E2 cell, that means 24. If you are clicking on the 24 means, then it will take the cell reference as E2, and then instead of PV, here clicking on the loan, that means 150,000 means that cell reference is C2, and click on the OK button, then it will display the answer in the cell. Answer will be displayed at the G2 cell, and the answer is 5,989 point some change. This is the amount we have to paid for the installment, and this is for installment plus interest. And this is only installment per month, and IPMT means only interest. How to calculate the interest means, again you have to go to the insert function dialog box, click on the IPMT and click on the OK button. Then you can see the IPMT dialog box. In this IPMT dialog box, you can see the rate. And per, here again I am taking 1. That means I am calculating it for only 1 month. And then NPR, select the month. That means, select the months means, again 24 months. That means the cell reference is E2. And then here, PV. Click on the C2 cell. That means click on the 150,000. It will display the C2 cell here. And click on the OK button, then it will display the answer in the cell. That means the interest is 625 rupees per month. This is the dialog box for insert function to create the PMT, PPMT and IPMT. And we can take it as the values in the Excel sheet. After entering the result in the Excel sheet, then click this cell and drag towards the downward direction. If you are dragging towards the downward direction up to F4, then the formula will be copied and pasted over here. And this data will be calculated and result will be appeared at this cell also. Select this cell and drag towards the downward direction. The formula will be applicable for each and every row in this section. This is the way to create the PMT, PPMT and IPMT. Here in financial functions, we have different functions like future value, present value, and PMT, IPMT, NPR, PR. Here I am taking the first value as FV. For this, we can write the syntax as, this is the syntax, that means FV bracket open. In this, we can calculate the rate, comma, and NPR, PMT, NPR, PMT, PV, and type. This is the formula for the future value. And next, PV means present value. And here, PV syntax is same again, rate, NPR, PMT, and FV, and type. This is the present value. And the next one is NPER. For NPR, the syntax is NPER, and then rate PMT, rate PMT, PV, FV, and type. Here NPR means number of periods. NPR means number of periods. And then next one is PMT. And for PMT, the syntax is PMT, and then rate PV, FV, and NPER, and then type. And here PMT means period of month time. And then the next one is PPMT. And the next PPMT is the payment on the principal. That means PPMT. And the syntax for this is rate and then per NPER and then future value, that means FV present value, and then type. These are the syntaxes in financial functions. That means present values for calculating, we have to enter this type of syntax. I already showed you that if you are opening the PMT worksheet, means you can see the rate over here, NPR, PV, FV, and type. This dialog box will be appear. If you click on the PV dialog box, means that means present value dialog box, means you can see the items like rate, NPR, PMT, FV, and type. For each and every option, this type of dialog box will be appear. In this dialog box, you have to enter some data. That means you have to enter some numbers in this boxes. And then after filling this one, click on the OK button. The result will be appeared in the Excel sheet. This is the way to calculate the financial function. And these are the types of financial functions. These type of functions will be used to calculate the present value and future value and the rate of interest, and then the installment plus interest. We can calculate the separate installment for 1 month, and we can calculate the interest for 1 month, and we can calculate the installment plus interest for 1 month. We can calculate that one, and you can see how much amount we have to pay for 1 month. This is the way to calculate the financial functions in Excel sheet. And then next type of function is date and time function. And the next function is date and time function. This is the second type of function in Excel. And for this also we have to take some Excel sheet. Here I am taking the row, column A, column B and column C, row 1, row 2 and then row 3. For calculating the date and time, for date means we have to calculate the date, that means day, month and year. For this we have to write the simple formulas also. How we can write the formulas means, if we want to current, if you want to represent the current date, means the formula is equal to symbol and you can enter now and empty bracket, then automatically the date will be appeared here. That means today's date is 1 cell and the formula will be displayed in FX bar, that means formula bar. Now and empty brackets. If you are entering this formula after 2 days, means after 2 days date will be displayed in the Excel sheet. This is the current date. And then if you want to display the day in the Excel sheet, means, or you can enter the formula for the total date, means write the formula for total date, that means date. Already current date is appear, no? And for this date I am adding some numbers to it and I am adding some number and displaying the other date in this Excel sheet. That means date. Here day is 13, that means I have to enter the cell reference here, day A1 plus 2 comma and then month A1 plus 1 and year A1 plus 2 and closing the formula. That means it will display the date. Day, here I entered 13. That means 13 plus 2. And month, I already entered 6. And here the adding one is 1. And year is 2020. And I am adding 2. That means it will display the date as 15 and 7. 92. That means the date and the date is 15/7/2022. The result will be appeared here. That means 15/7/2022. This is the way to add some days, months and years in the current date. And you can add some days to the day separately and for year also you can add some years separately and for months also we can add some days. And here I am taking the date as 14/6/2020. I am entering the date as 14/6/2020. And in the formula bar, I have to write formula for only month. That means month A1 means only the month number will be displayed in the active cell. This is the active cell. The result will be appeared here, and the month is 6. The 6 number will be appeared here. And I am selecting this cell, and for month I have to, for year I have to write formula. That means for year equal to symbol year A1, then year will be displayed here. That means 2020. That means 2020. For day A1. For this, the result will be displayed in C3 cell. Day is 14. The first one is month, and the second one is the year, and the third one is the day. Here I am separating the month, year, day in the Excel sheet by using this date format. We can write the formulas for month separately, year separately, and day separately. And the next way to enter formula is we can add days for the current date. That means I am entering the formula as A1 plus 3. I am entering the date as formula as day A1 plus 3. That means day is 14 plus 3. That means the number is 17. 17 will be displayed as the result. And then the next one is month. For month, again month A1 plus 1 I am adding here. That means the month number is 6 plus 1. That means 7. 7 will be displayed in the cell. And then year. Year A1 plus 2. That means already entered in the before formula as 2 only. Here I am entering only 1 here. And the year is 2020 and plus 1, 2021 will be displayed here. This is the way to write formulas for days, months, and years in the Excel sheet. We can write the month separately, year separately, day separately, day plus adding some number here and displaying the result, month plus adding some number and displaying the result, year plus number adding one number here and displaying the result over here. And the already I wrote the formula for current date is now. This formula is used for the current date. And then I am taking the formula for whole date. That means here I am writing the formula for the whole date and adding some numbers in it, or adding only for some numbers in it. That means here date bracket open, and first one is the year I am writing in the reverse process, that is month A1 plus 1 comma day A1 comma year A1 plus 1 and closing the bracket. Here it will display month is 6 and here I am adding 1. That means 6 plus 1 will be displayed. That means 7. And day. Here day is 14 I didn't enter any number for the day. It will display same as this, and year is 2020 plus 1. That means 2021. Here the date will be 7/14/2021. The results will be displayed in the A2 cell. That means 7/14/2021. Here you have to notice one thing. This is the month and this is the day and this is year. In this format, date will be represented as in two styles. One is we are using slash and one is hyphen symbol. And these two symbols will be used to represent the date. How you are writing the date in Excel means, the way is day, month, year, or day, month, or year. And this is the one format, and you can display only years. That means last two digits only it will be categorized. The first two digits won't be accepted. The last two digits of the year will be displayed here. And you can write in this format also. That means slash year. And you can change month as first and day as the second and year as the last. By using these two symbols, we are presenting the date in the Excel sheet and the Excel sheet will be accepted. And then here I am adding some numbers to the day and for year and for month, and I am displaying the current date. And here using the different styles here, that means that is the symbols we entered for the displaying date, and we are adding only number for the month and we are adding only for the year. And you can write the formula for only year and not for the day and month. That means here I am writing date, here I am displaying the day first, day A1 comma, and next one is month A1 comma year A1 plus 3 I am entering here, and the date will be displayed as A1 is 14 and month is 6 and the year is actually 2020, but I am adding 3 here and it will display 2023 here. For each and every formula, here I am taking the A1 here. Why I am displaying A1 means I am using this date to represent the different dates in the Excel sheet. Here I am entered the date in the A1 cell. I am using this cell reference ID to enter formula. If you want to write formula for A2 cell means you can enter here date, day, A2, month, A2 plus 1 and year A2. This is the formula for A2 cell reference, and it will display in A2 cell the month is 7 and 7 is the month here. That means 7 plus 1 and the year is 2021 and the day is 14. That means it will display 14/8/2021. The answer will be displayed in the A3 cell. You can use any of the cell in your Excel sheet to display the result or to write the formula in the Excel sheet. We can enter month separately or year separately or day separately. We can enter the formula for month as first and day as second and year as the third one. And these are the formats to enter days and months and years in the time and date function. And here is the, again, second one is time here. We can write the formula for time also. And here I'm taking another column for enter time. And here I'm entering time as 11. And for this B1 cell, I can write the formula for time. That means equal to time, bracket open. And here the first one is the hour, and this cell reference is D1. Here I am entering D1 and closing that cell reference bracket, and I am adding plus 1 here, comma, and these are the minutes. That means here I am writing the minutes, and same D1 cell. And didn't enter any number here, and then seconds. D1 and closing the bracket. That means the hour is 11 hours. I am adding plus 1, that means 12. Here minutes is the already 0 minutes, and seconds is also 0. That means the time will be displayed here as 12. If you want to enter some numbers to the minutes and seconds means, you can enter the formula for time, hour. I'm entering the formula for D2 cell, D2 plus or D2 comma minutes as D2 cell, and entering some number as 5, comma, second, and for second D2 cell, and I'm entering the number as 2 and closing the bracket. Here D2 is 12, here hour is 12, it will display 12, and the minute is 00, but I'm adding 5 here. That means it will display 5, and 0 seconds I am adding 2 here and 2 seconds. That means 12 minutes, 12 hours, 5 minutes, 2 seconds. The answer will be displayed in the D3 cell. Here you have to notice one thing. For time, you are representing the colon symbol. In the date means you are representing the slash and hyphen symbols. For time, you are representing the column symbol in between the hours and minutes over here. If you want to enter only hours means, you can write the formula as hour D1. Then the result will be appeared. That means here I am taking the D1 cell. In D1 cell, the hour is 11. For minute also, you can write the formula. That means here I am taking D2. In D2, minutes is 0. It will display the 0. And then for second, here I am taking the D3 cell. That means in D3 cell, you can see the seconds as 0, 2. The answer will be displayed here. This is the way to enter the time and date. Current date you can enter, or you can add something. In this time also, we are adding hours, minutes, seconds. we are displaying only hours and minutes and seconds separately in the Excel sheet by using the current time or sample document you are taking, and then for that document we are adding some numbers and displaying the result in the Excel sheet, the document you are taking in the Excel sheet. This is the way to enter the date and time in the Excel sheet. I hope you understand. Thank you.